good.
I'm good. Good.
Buddy ready? Let's get rolling. I'm Sergeant David Boyd, D-A-V-I-D, B-O-Y-D, Austin Police Department. Worked in the intersection control. Yesterday at about 6:15 p.m., APD responded to 1109 South Cliff Valley at the Town Lake Student Apartments. The caller reported his roommate had gotten in some kind of argument with another tenant in the apartment complex, gone over to the apartment to apologize to that person. When that roommate entered the suspect's apartment, somehow the suspect was not very receptive to come over to apologize and tried forcing the pillows down his throat. The victim then fled out of the apartment, which was apparently on a second-story apartment, jumped off the balcony, and ran away. Officers and EMS were called out to the scene due to the pills being forced down his throat. When officers made contact with the victim, he described a black male to him. The officers that initially responded to this call had previously been out of that complex about an hour earlier on the exact same subject, and they knew which apartment he lived in, so they went to go make contact with him. As they were walking over towards his apartment, the suspect was outside the apartment, saw them coming, and took off running through the apartment complex. He went westbound from the complex out to Pleasant Valley and then continued running through traffic from Pleasant Valley going southbound towards Elmont. Officers engaged in a quick pursuit of the suspect at this time. Called it out on the radio. There is a couple of gang unit officers that just happened to be nearby coming down Pleasant Valley. Saw the suspect running, jumped out of their car, and tried to stop the suspect. They initially tried pulling a taser on the subject. At some point during the scuffle with the suspect, he was able to get the taser away from one of the officers and began using that taser on the officers that were trying to subdue him. More officers arrived on the scene, and during the scuffle, the suspect took the taser and delivered several strikes with the butt end of the taser to the head of one of the patrol officers that responded, causing some serious lacerations on his head. Once enough officers we're on the scene, we're finally able to get the vehicle under control. Altogether, we ended up having 5 officers go to Brackenridge to get treatment from the scuffle with this suspect. 2 of them are still out on light duty, and the other 3 are back to work today.
Were officers actually tased or just hit with the taser?
The best way to describe it is it's called like a drive stun. They didn't have the prongs come out and hit them. But the suspect had it in his hand, was holding the trigger down, and he was actively sparking on the end, and was using that as they were trying to secure.
How often, going back to the suspect, is it appear that he was hopped up on something, or mental illness, or what's the...
We're still looking into that to figure out what all the elements were and why this happened like that.
Just unknown what kind of drugs he was.
The suspect forced pills down the throat of someone else.
Yes, sir.
How frequently?
You know, it's a good point. It happens a lot. And in this case, it's not necessarily just an assisting EMS call. Force and pills, some points on the service, assault on the person, so it doesn't lose that call as well.
Would you say that EMS people are often at risk?
It can be. It just depends on the call. It's hard to say. You know, each call is a little different, but the 911 call takers try to assess what the call is when they're taking that initial call, and if it sounds like something that they're going to need police assistance, they obviously will call us. And EMS will typically stay a block or so away before they approach the scene, but it doesn't sound like the scene to be secure.
What would be the typical protocol that would determine the APD should be called in as well?
Probably some kind of disturbance going on, something with violence. A lot like what happened yesterday where somebody tried to force some pills in somebody's throat. Be something we can get to, obviously.
What's the status of the suspect now?
He was booked into jail last night. We anticipate that the charges will be filed today. Detectives still have to interview
And those charges could well be.
Right now, we're looking at aggravated assault on a police officer and taking a weapon from a police officer. And there could be potential more charges coming up.
Do you know what his bond status is?
Until the affidavits are filed.
Do you know the status of the victim?
As far as I know, he's okay. I did not get transported, and in the end, multiple officers got after the drive stun. One officer ended up getting several staples on top of his head and stitches in his forehead. The other one was still out of my vision because of his forehead right at the end from fighting.
Was proper protocol followed in terms of the officer? How did the taser get taken from him?
All of that's still going to be part of our review and investigation still, so we haven't had time to fully review all the videos at this point. Some drugs kind of cause people not to feel pain. So we don't know if the system actually was on anything or not, but if he was, there's some people that depending on the drug you're taking, they just don't feel pain. So being compliant stimulants don't work.
The pills you force down the other person's throat, do you know what those are?
Yes, sir.
Do we know the suspect's like name, age, anything?
That'll all be available once the affidavit is filed.
Is there a video of this incident?
There was multiple patrol vehicles pointed in several different directions. Like I said, we haven't got a chance to review all the video yet, but from my understanding and looking at the way the cars were pointed, the majority of everything should be captured on video. Anything else?
Was the suspect actually ever successfully tagged?
Most of that taken put out?
No, I don't know.
That's good
security. I don't know.
Are you releasing the suspect's name?
Once the affidavit's filed. And like I said, it should be later this evening. Anything else?
Good.
Okay. Thank you guys.
Thank you.